out to the inmates in the maximum security section of the largest prison facility in the Philippines. So we'll find out what happened. It's very exciting. I would also like to encourage you to keep praying for our vision to expand. You know, we've met with the Archdiocese, the one in charge of the property. He's the manager of the property management department. And he showed us different churches or chapels that are up for sale, four or five, you know, Assumption, St. Vincent, and of course, we know St. Andrew's for sale, Holy Family. And there's one more, St. Michael. So all those buildings, all those chapels are up for sale. But we're looking at either we expand this facility. We've got three lots, and Lord willing, if the Lord opens the possibility of buying this one, then you know, we have better opportunities to really expand. So, because right now the shape of our property is not really like one hole like this, right? So you notice that instead of if you look at our parking lot, it stops here. So and then of course we have the other side. So praise God that the Lord is not allowing us to be content where we are and not grow and not have any vision. So we want to dream dreams, it's true, but it's got to be aligned with His will for us. Because we don't want to do anything presumptuous. We don't want to do anything that's not according to His will. We've got to search His heart. And if you look at your announcements and bulletins and the email that's being sent, you know, by Melvin, on a regular basis. Now it includes a whole calendar for the year. That's not all. You know, we will have more, but it tells you the direction where we're going as well. You know, quarterly we're gonna have a prayer Sunday here. On a monthly basis, the men's fellowship will be meeting, and just as the ladies are already meeting on a monthly basis. We will have a course that will be offered in the months of April and May. And so if you're interested, you know, we will not limit the enrollees for that course. It's about learning how to study and share the Bible. So you'll be able to learn how to teach, or if you're called to preach, then that will be a good course for you. Okay, so be prayerful, because every one of us must have a ministry. Like I said, you know, I've emphasized that. And the month of January, and I cannot under-emphasize that, right, or emphasize that enough. And so we continue to encourage you to plug into any kind of ministry where you can get involved and share your gifts and your talents and do it for God's glory. Let's not just be spectators in the ministry, right? But let's actively pursue the vision that God has given us. All right, we're going to pray today. It's good to see Mercy, you know. And I told her, please don't come to church today, just rest. And she said, Pastor, I'd like to come to church. Even if I walk just very slowly, I'd still come. And that, to me, as I was telling Brother Monte, is dedication.
Amen.
That is dedication. She's not looking for an excuse for not to come, but she's looking for a reason to come. Just like Sister Lita, you know, with her foot. Ati Irma. And we know she's taken to the hospital. And so, we have been tested in the area of health, or the physical, right? And there's so many testings in life, but just be faithful. And no matter what happens to us, just like, you know, Acts 20:24, but not Paul said, but none of these things move me, neither count I my life dear unto myself, that I might finish my course with joy and the ministry that He has given to me. So, let's do it with joy, all right? So, praise the Lord. We're going to collect our offerings today, and we will have a special offering today. Let me encourage you, okay? I've been in touch with Justine lately, especially her birthday, right? We sent greetings to her, and I chat with her sometimes, and just to find out, you know, how she's doing. She's doing very well. She's one of the most outstanding students there in the Bible school, and they love her there. They want to keep her there. They offer her some ministry opportunities, and they really want her there. But I'm praying that she would come back because I encourage her to take part in discipling our young girls, you know, and helping them grow in the Word and grow in their spiritual walk with the Lord. And she's planning to come back here in May, if I'm not mistaken, and stay here. But we are raising funds so that we can buy a plane ticket for her, okay? And thank God the airfares these days are, you know, very cheap. Cheap, okay? But we don't know if it's going to go up because the price of oil went up a little bit. So we don't know. Sometimes that dictates, you know, the cost of transportation. So so if you would care to give, you know, towards this purpose to bring her back, one way, we're not going to buy a round trip ticket. Okay, it'll be one way, and so we will appreciate that. So let us please help Justine. I don't remember ever collecting an offering for her. Have we? I don't remember. Have we done it before? No. So this is going to be the first time, and she's been there for a while now. So take part in her training. She really loves the Lord, and she loves to serve the Lord. So may you bless her that way for God's glory. Just pray. Father, thank you for the opportunity that we have to serve you, to honor you, and to be able to worship you. Thank you for this privilege. And oh, how wonderful it is to know, oh God, that you are the center of everything that we do. Help us not to miss out on that full purpose for everything that we do. May you be right there in the middle of it all, at the center. So that we do things and it's not about us, nothing about us, oh God. Whether it be for our growth or our salvation, or for whatever it is, for our welfare, everything is to honor you. We've always believed in the principle that we're blessed. We are super blessed in many, many ways, abundantly blessed, in order for us to be a blessing. And so, Lord, in some humble ways today, may we honor you through whatever we can share to others. Thank you that you've given us the opportunity to help our neighbors, Eli and Don, move and continue to pray for them. They desire to serve you. They desire to continue to be a part of our church, oh God, but you've directed them somewhere else, and I pray that you'd use them. And we also pray for the opportunity now to be of help to Justine. And Lord, may you bless every effort that we have to reach out to our brothers and sisters, but first of all, to the household of faith, to the family of God, to those who are in need. While it is good to help homeless people and fire victims, oh Lord God, and we've done that by your grace, and victims of calamities, oh Lord, but it's very good. It's our pleasure to help those that are part of the household of faith. And so, Lord, bless us as we envision to grow larger and bigger, not only in our facility, but, Lord, even in our hearts and our spirituality. May we walk closer to you, dear God. We thank you for our brothers and sisters who, in spite of their health condition, they make it a point to come and worship with us, maybe uncomfortable, maybe not easy, but yet they make efforts, and we are blessed. We are encouraged by that, oh God. Thank you for healing them and answering our prayers. And we continue to ask that you touch their health, their lives, oh Lord God, and bring wellness and strength, oh God, and restoration. We pray for your special blessing upon those that cannot come for whatever reason, that you address their needs and meet their needs, oh God. We ask, oh Lord, today that you would allow us to see you in our lives and in our ministry. Speak to us, oh Lord God. Draw us closer to you, closer than ever, and help us to realize that our time here on earth is so limited. We're living on borrowed time, and we don't know how much longer we will have to live in this world. While we are excited about many things here in this life, and we enjoy so many things that you have blessed us with, oh Lord God, help us not to lose a focus on who you are, your worth, how we must value you in our lives, how you must have the preeminence in our lives, that we will give you the highest honor, the top priority. Help us to do that, O Lord God, because the things of the world tend to replace you in our hearts, and we know that that would be idolatry, that would be covetousness, and you will not be pleased with that. But there's reason you bless us. There's reason you have given us jobs, that we receive paychecks, O Lord God. And so we pray that you help us to be faithful to the cause for which you bless us. And allow us, Father God, to see the direction that you're leading us. We don't know what you will give to us, but we would like to ask from you by faith. We would like to exercise our faith and our confidence is in you, not upon what we can do, but it's on what you can do, and there's no limit to that. Your power is boundless and your grace is free. And so, Lord, continue to pour your blessings on us, blessings spiritual. That's what we ask for, more blessings spiritual, that there will be more souls that will be saved, that you motivate us to win souls, O Lord God. And those that have been shared a gospel with, I pray that they will respond. Those who have been won, I pray that they will grow. And Lord, as we continue today, we ask that you will be given full honor and glory, even the testimony that we will hear today. So we commit to you and dedicate this offering. And again, we thank you for your love, and we dedicate to you this day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, so let's welcome Victoria to the front and come and share to us how the Lord has blessed the ministry that you have been given the opportunity to reach out to the inmates. You know, we prayed for their salvation. We prayed for the Christians there to be blessed.